Hello guys, my name is Michael Chung and welcome to another 2JZ Tuesday series. And today I'm going to answer some of your questions regarding camshaft. How to read a cam card. Before you know how to read a cam card, you need to understand three more things other than the things that I've explained in the previous video. If you guys haven't watched, you can go ahead and watch, which will be displayed here. The previous video I talked about the camshaft timing, the basic terminology such as lift, duration, base circle. I also discussed about what is camshaft overlap. And then the third one is I discussed about the 2JZ cam options. So follow this link if you guys still haven't watched it, and watch it before watching this video. The first one is top dead center. That means the piston reaches the top and then it cannot move any further. Okay, that is the top dead center. And then the other one is bottom dead center. That means the piston travels to the most bottom, to the lowest point, and then it cannot travel any further down. And the third thing is the 0.05 inch valve lift. When the cam just started to open the valve, and just before ending, lifting the valve. What are the differences for the same duration of 2JZ cams between brands? Different brands may advertise the same duration, but what are the differences between these two cams? Of course there is a difference, but how to know it? Okay, for example, 264 and 264 cams. Okay, the key is you need to know what is the profile of those cams. How to know those profiles is you have to see what is the 0.05 inch of valve opening. If you can notice that when there are two brands, they have different degrees in this 0.05 cam lift, whichever brand that has earlier opening the 0.05 inch means it has a more aggressive cam profile. That's the trick to know what's the difference between the cams from these two brands. Okay, the third question is, what is valve float? Okay, when cams with very aggressive profile and running at high RPM, it will cause the spring tension not enough to press the valve onto its seat and makes the valve float momentarily when it bounces back. Okay, so when it happens, there can be some catastrophic damage to your valve or to your valve seat. Okay, mostly is the valve will bend first. Okay, so this is what we don't want, and then this is the limiting factor by the valve train. Got two options. One is you reduce your RPM. Two is you replace your valve train to become a lighter, lower inertia, and maybe higher spring rate, so that in order to press the valve onto its seat. Okay guys, give you some more tips when you are buying cams, whether it is new or secondhand or used camshafts. Okay. The longer the duration, or the higher the number it is, the higher lift it has, and the higher end power it will have. That means it will sacrifice the low end power. It will definitely have rough idle too. Okay, so don't be too alarmed about it and be prepared for it. Okay, there is no such thing as best for both worlds. If you want power, you need to sacrifice the low end idling. You have to sacrifice your comfort. The second thing is, if you are buying a second hand cam, always try to inspect all the surfaces of the cams, whether they are still very smooth. Try to do the nail test and see whether it can pass or not. Third is, try to get the cam card from them. Okay, if you can't, better make sure you ask from Mr. Google first. The fourth one is specifically for 2JZ. 2JZ has three types. The first one is 2JZ NA or 2JZ GE with distributor. That means it has the distributor teeth for it. The second one is 2JZ non-VVTi. The third one is 2JZ VVTi. So these two is very different in terms of the intake place. There is a slot for VVTi. So if you are using VVTi head, you have to machine the 2JZ non-VVTi cam so that it can fit into the 2JZ VVTi head. Okay, I got two bonuses for you guys. The first one is things to notice when you are installing cams. Okay, camshafts and crankshafts are the same. They are fed from the oil pump and provide oil to lubricate the cam. However, the overhead camshaft does not have those bearings to protect the cylinder head. So that means if you are using dirty oil or insufficient oil, you make the camshaft to scratch onto your cylinder head, which means you may need to replace the whole cylinder head. Even BC recommends to put ample amount of engine assembly lube so that it will prevent the camshaft from seizing, okay, and destroy your cylinder head. Okay, the last thing I'm going to talk about is the future of cams. Because camshaft and its assembly, it may include the rocker arm, the camshaft, the timing belt, and the cam gears. All of them has energy dissipation, which accounted to almost 25%. Some of the high-tech companies are using solenoid to actuate valve. Conisec has developed an electric valve actuator to improve the fuel efficiency, and it can save space too. What I believe in the future is there will be lesser and lesser camshafts be used because it will reduce all the energy losses, and you can adjust all the duration. The lift maybe you cannot adjust, but the duration, the profile, everything you can adjust. So I believe that's the future of camshaft.
Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos, and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you!